Hello, this is Emma, and this is Super Chill with Supacolor. Supacolor produce high quality custom heat transfers for you to press onto garments. They're super high quality, easy to use, and long lasting, but they sound nice as well. So tonight we're going to be pressing our own custom t-shirts, and we have two designs. This is the first. Sounds like a windy day when you're nice and cozy inside. Sweet little fluffy, sleepy, happy cloud sitting on the sofa with super chill underneath. I love the sound at the back. The transfer on the back of the sheet. It has a nice grainy texture. And a lovely sound. Cute little rosy cheeks. Next one. Another rainbow. This time, orange. Mustard, grey, and brown. Super chill. The end of the rainbow. This is in the style, the super colour. Okay. They will look nice on your t-shirt. Three. Four. identify the color of the t-shirt. And of course we have our garments. So we have sky blue t-shirt, all pressed and ready to go. And we have a white t-shirt. So if you'd like to follow me to the press, we can get started. Okay. So we're all warmed up and ready to start. Our heat press is set to 160 degrees Celsius, which is 320 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay. Our timer is set to 15 seconds. This here is our heat plate, and of course that's very hot, so we will be careful there. And this here is the rubber surface for your garment. We need to adjust the pressure of the press to firm as well. And the way to do that is to close the press just a little, like this, and adjust this mechanism here, tighten it so that the handle will not quite close, and then adjust again just so that it does. So you have it on the tightest, firmest pressure for your press. Okay, and then it's ready to use. So let's load our t-shirt on to the rubber plate. Now, whichever way works for you is best, but with shirt, you can load it on by opening up the bottom and placing it over this way here, or this way, which works for me on this press. Okay. Now it's worth taking the time here to make sure that your t-shirt is placed centrally on the plate can measure how much material is on either side there if you want to, or you can go by the measurements, the distance from the line here of the arms. But what you always want to make sure is that you don't have any collar, any detail inside the pressing area. Okay, so the collar there is tucked away at the back, and all we have is a flat surface for the pressing. Okay, so smooth it down. Take your time. There we are. Okay, so I like to now take a lint roller and just go over the surface, the transfer area especially. If you have pets or anything else that may be on the garment, it's good to take that off just in case. So let's do that. Gently next you can just do a little pre-press as well, which is quite important to do, especially with thicker material. Perhaps if you were doing a hoodie or a thicker cotton, the pre-press will just press the material and steam out any moisture that may be there. It'll also make it nice and flat and ironed out for you as well, just in case. So let's do that. Okay, and if you see any steam coming up, you can always do it again, just until you're happy that your garment is ready to press. Okay, so here we have our transfer printing with Supacolor. Is super easy. You just send in your artwork and they turn it into Supacolor for you. This is the world's best heat transfer, and it's all ready to press. Let's place it on our t-shirt. Okay. If you want to, you can measure. You can go by sight. Whatever you're happy with. But if your t-shirt is placed perfectly, you can get a good idea of where the center is, where you want it placed, either towards the neck or further down, depending on the size of your t-shirt as well. Okay? So once you're happy, we can press. And while your transfer is pressing, perhaps you can have a little daydream in those 15 seconds. And you're going to peel the backing quickly, low and confidently. Ready? And after the peel, if you would like to, you can do a post press with some parchment paper just to seal the edges. Place your parchment over the top, smooth it down, and post press. Once your design has cooled down, you can feel the lovely soft hand of the transfer. It's super soft. And there we have it. Shall we press and peel some more? Okay, let's do that. you enjoyed that little super color t-shirt pressing tutorial. I hope you enjoyed the sounds and I hope you feel lovely, calm and relaxed. Good night. Sleep tight.